wasting away with rats nibbling at your toes.
Oh, Victor, I hope my baby inherits your rich imagination.
So, Granddad, shall I call Cook? Have him order up some crow for you to eat.
Really? What did Kayla say?
That you are carrying my child.
I didn't even know you were back.
Well, you told me Jack got his memory back. Did you think I was going to stay in Phoenix?
Please.
And then he told me you were celebrating tonight, and I thought, you know what? I'll take me a piece of that.
she insisted.
Yeah.
Honey, your text said Jack wanted us to join them.
Well, yeah, you know he never says straight out what he wants.
You don't think you heard what you wanted to hear,
oh,
maybe?
Oh, please, you're just being crummy because you had to schlep the suitcase. Well, who cares who those two, huh? I mean, we're all here. Jack remembers his past, including how awful Eve Donovan was, is, and always will be.
No, we don't need to talk about Eve tonight. Yeah.
Yeah, you know, and maybe Jack and Jennifer would like to be alone.
Mom.
Oh, my God!
Hey!
So, which is the most delicious?
You.
We talked about this. You have to focus on the issue at hand. Do you think planning a wedding is fun? Romantic?
Well, it's not. It's work.
Okay. All right. We can try the icing. All right.
Okay.
Is this sweet enough for you?
Do not think I don't know what you're up to.
So it's not working.
Damn it, Eli. You know it works. It always works.
Wait, come here. You had a little bit left over on your lips. Well, I like it. Do you?
No.
Liar. All right, I'm just playing. I'm messing around with you.
Look. Jack, why don't you get the waitress to push a couple tables together?
As if your mother needs any help when it comes to pushing.
Come on, you can sit by me, Sonny.
Well, actually, Mama, we're here with Gabby.
Oh.
Gabby. Nice to see you.
What a coincidence. Sonny and Will dragged out the grieving widow to cheer me up.
Good for them.
What is this? I see you have a sweet tooth.
No, we're just choosing our wedding cake.
Oh. Stefan and I, we never got to have a reception. Actually, we didn't get to do a lot of things. Here you are, picking your wedding cake. I have to pick out his suit for his funeral.
Gabby, I'm really, really sorry.
He's got a lot of suits, so it's gonna be hard, but... Look at me. I'm such a Debbie Downer. I'm sorry. I should be apologizing to you. I was terrible when you asked me for Stefan's heart, and I said terrible things.
You were grieving.
All's well that ends well. Stefan's heart saved a life, so... That brings me comfort. Don't worry. Pick your cake and your wedding. Just because I lost my husband doesn't mean you don't get to be happy.
You deserve to be happy, do you? Say it. Bonnie, I don't deserve to be happy. Or the crazy lady could renege on the deal. Take it all back and all this kneeling. It'd be for nothing. Say it. I don't deserve to be happy.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Sonny.
Well,
You know what? Aunt Jen told me that Julie is getting a pacemaker. Well, that is great news, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah, once she gets that, she's going to be good as new. Yeah, I can testify that her new heart is top of the line.
Well, it was nice seeing both of you. Let's go. I'm starving.
I don't have much of an appetite these days. But, you know, that looks pretty good. I'll go for that one.
Yeah.
I told you I was telling the truth. But I understand your caution. Just to verify.
Well, now it's a fact. This is my child.
Our child.
I need a drink.
I think this validates my decision to move Kristen into the house, don't you think?
Does it also validate you're putting your job in jeopardy?
Victor, now that we're going to be family, maybe you should stop threatening to fire Brady so that we can all make a fresh new start.
Too late for that.
What do you mean?
Sorry to interrupt. I've come to tell you that I accept your job.
Showing up here while we're having a great time planning a wedding and she's going through hell?
Because of me. Eli, can we just pick a cake and get the hell out of here?
Babe, I know that wasn't fun for you. But when Gabby gave Julie Stefan's heart, I really think that was the first step of her getting past what happened.
What? Don't you have something to say to Jack, dear?
Well, since you said that loud enough for him to hear,
yes, I do. You know, that's one thing I remember about my sister. She could always steer a conversation. Justin, you had something you wanted to say to me.
Yes, well, you know, now that you've got your memory back, I just want to say I'm sorry for representing Eve in court.
I want you to know I totally pitched a fit about that as well, just so you know.